Hello, everybody. My name is Ray. Welcome to Horizon Zero Dawn. I'm here with Rainbow.
Hey, guys.
We just literally got back from town, picked up this game, and now we're going to start it. All right. Let's see what it has to offer.
All right. So excited.
I've been super excited for this game. Finally coming out.
Oh, man.
I almost don't want to talk.
No, let's just enjoy the moment.
What's that now? Don't like the cold? Can't stand today. Yeah. We have a ritual to perform, you and I. Today, I speak your name, girl. But will the goddess speak it back?
Ray, it's so pretty.
Oh, it really is. Wow.
I didn't think it would be this beautiful.
Normally, it would be the mother who declares, if you had one. The whole village would attend, and matriarchs perform the ritual, but we are outcasts. Even so, we keep the tribe's rituals. Otherwise, we might become like the faithless old ones who turned their backs on the goddess. But their wickedness doomed them. To us, we're left the splendors of creation, beasts of air, water, earth, and steel.
No, I haven't watched any of the trailers for any of the releases we've played. Oh, holy shit. Fuck yes.
It is one thing to hunt a beast, another to hunt a machine. You must be humble and respect their power. I will teach you this one day. What is she doing here? Does she mean to forbid the ritual?
Well, she's not stopping him. That's good.
No, 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 off your knees. It's nearly time. And yes, you may speak to me.
You came to bless the naming.
Have not 6 months gone by since we entrusted her to you?
But we are outcasts.
You by choice. And she, well... I am a high matriarch, Rost. I bless whom I choose.
Then you honor us.
Yes, yes. Now go and be ready to declare. Go!
Aw, that's sweet.
In our own way, yeah.
All mother, this child needs a name by which to know her. That your love may warm her life as the rising sun warms all the earth. Speak her name! And so her name is blessed.
Stop this at once! What have you done?
I've blessed the naming of a child.
Stubborn woman, you call that curse a child? What did she tell you about his birth, outcast? Answer!
I've done only what you asked.
To raise it, yes. We said nothing of love.
Enough.
And you, blessing its name like it was one of the...
I know my duty to them. And to you.
Without consultation.
I'm here. And wherever you go, I will follow.
That other old lady's a bitch.
Mm-hmm. I see that.
Probably because she can't get no loving.
Probably.
Hell yes. What an
Alright, we're back. Alright, let's start a new game. I just started normal.
For real.
Aloy!
Oh.
Aloy!
Oh, that's a lot of berries.
You're quite the gatherer, aren't you, little bast? Now go and see if you can find some more, hmm? Well done, that's a good boy. Children, come with me.
Aww.
She's an outcast, to be shunned.
I want to know why. Is it because she's a fucking redhead?
I wonder.
Because she's like the only redhead.
Come on.
Bottom.
Ross! He won't hear me. Some kind of cave?
Oh, shit. We are already playing. Okay.
Yep, gotta get used to the controller, Ray.
Yes, I do.
No keyboard and mouse for you here.
Is there no way to adjust the sensitivity? Really? Oh my god. Okay, I'll live.
Down here.
Go into the cave. I'm kind of already in the cave, aren't I? I thought.
You can go deeper into the cave. I mean, you don't have to worry about anything. She's a ginger, so she can't get her soul stolen.
well, there's my... What? Oh yeah, don't worry. She's a ginger. It's fine.
I bet that's why she's an outcast. Because she doesn't have a soul.
That's my... That is seriously my theory.
But I can get through.
That actually is my theory right now, too. Is because, you know, red hair.
Exactly.
It has nothing to do with souls or my opinion on gingers.
Except that they suck.
This must be a ruin of the metal world.
Oh, I can't really talk. I've got the red hair gene myself. Just only in my beard. Which is weird.
I think it's like a recessive trait in my family. Or, you know, something like that. That I had red hair when I was little, and then it just kind of darkened as I got older. Which I'm thankful for.
What on earth?
Touch it.
What am I gonna do? Head smash it?
Yeah, blah! That's what I meant. No, touch it with your penis.
She's sick. She doesn't have a penis.
With her dick.
She doesn't have a dick.
You're just not trying hard enough.
I love how it correlated her age to the fact that she doesn't have a dick. Like, oh no, she'll grow a dick once she gets older.
Go through the door.
Ross said never go in places like this.
Well, Ross isn't fucking here. Oh my god.
Okay.
Ross ain't fucking here, is he? Chairs.
Oh. Oh.
I'm gonna take a seat. Can't take a seat. Oh,
yeah, that works.
So, oh, piss.
Fuck. I bet that's where they executed people.
All the other soulless gingers.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Oh, my headphones are slipping.
Heh, loser. What is this, a lab? This is a lab.
I still don't have my lucky recording hat because I keep forgetting to bring it in here.
I bet this is where those machine creatures were made.
Now that you mention it, yeah, it does kind of look.
Except this is way too fucking. Never mind, that's a pretty big area. It might be. Let's discover more.
Can't get in there. Hey. Oh, but there's something shiny.
Yeah, exactly, there's a thing in there, which I bet I have to get to somehow.
Yeah.
Let's keep going.
Either have to get to it somehow or you come back for it later.
I don't know if I would be able to come back for it later. Like, I probably have to do it while I'm here, because the beginning gap was, like, super small. The music stopped?
Yeah.
That is... Oh.
That's always a bad sign.
Oh, wait. Okay. There's, like, no seamless audio change. It's just, like, sudden. That's weird. Okay. Oh, fuck. Can we not?
Yeah, let's do it.
Like, can we just
she
not?
She can kill it with her dick.
She doesn't have a dick.
It's because I'm assuming her gender.
Well, quit assuming genders.
No fuck you?
No fuck you.
Hey, no fuck you.
If we were trying
to... she can use her manpower.
What's that?
You don't know? She could be a man on the inside.
I don't give a fuck what her pronouns are. She's a little red-haired girl, and that's that.
Okay.
Hey, look, there's that thing.
Fair enough.
No, I think
that's a different shiny thing.
That's a different shiny thing.
There's something shiny there.
Oh, hey! Me and Red are on the same page. Oh, God. Now give it a kiss. Use the triangle button to inspect the strange device. What the fuck?
Right? It's gonna jump at her. It's beeping. It was beeping. Hey, you stick it outside your hand. Hand, head. That stuck to your brain. No, she ripped it off. Put it back on.
Don't be a little bitch.
Right.
Come on, you can do this. You were born for this.
It's not like you have a soul to lose.
Oh shit, that the stuff, like the debris falling in the background. I thought there was something coming up behind you.
Oh. It's a neural network. Oh.
Whoa.
Everywhere. How does he do this?
Oh shit.
There's Dude.
A lot going on in this area. Find a way out. Okay. So you can only walk while you're focusing. You can't run. Yet. I don't know if you can run when you're on or not. There's a thing up there. Where are you? Oh, I can't do anything. Can I?
I would imagine that they would give you a prompt when you could inspect something.
No, you never know.
Oh, are you stuck?
Yeah, I was stuck. I was temporarily stuck. Oh, look, he gave me a waypoint. Oh. Blast door heavily shielded, seal integrity maintained. Well, that's not a way out, unless there's a key for it. No, because that's a pretty heavy blast door, so...
A metal door. Closed.
You are very observational.
Maybe this device I found can help. How do I get it open?
Use the device to scan the room. If I didn't have the turning radius of a dead turtle while I was focusing...
That is, That is a bit of a downside.
Yeah, well...
It's, like, super sensitive when you're not focused, and then when you are focused, it's like, we'll get there one day.
Well, I'm perfectly fine with us not being super sensitive. Why did I tag that? Was there any real purpose in that?
No, but I guess it's a good thing you figured it out now.
Piss off. Alright, whatever. It was stupid. We'll get there eventually.
One day.
Heavily shielded.
A shape. It's connected to the door somehow.
Data shows require settings for nearby hollow locks. Is there something else to lock on?
More lights.
Power cables? Wait, what's the description on this? Reinforced platinum. Jesus.
This is insane.
Oh, here we go. I found it. Wait. Electromagnetic security mechanism. Interface unavailable. Turn counterclockwise and clockwise.
Changed color.
Power status on. Okay, cool.
Okay, so I think we can open it now.
I did a thing.
Congratulations.
Yay. And it didn't take me a fucking half hour to figure out.
And see, without a soul, she can figure these things out quickly.
Indeed. She doesn't have one of those crummy souls to slow down.
Nothing as silly as emotion to slow you down or anything.
Right.
Oh. Cool, alright.
That's a simplified puzzle. I like that.
And everything's purple.
I don't like purple.
I mean, I like purple, but I'm definitely more of a fan of blue. I really want to know why she's an outcast.
Yeah, I really want to.
They mentioned something about her birth, and it's like, oh, I was instantly interested. Right? I'm like, what the shit happened?
I have to know. Like...
All jokes aside, it can't be just because she's a redhead. There's gotta be another factor to it.
There has to be something. And like, apparently she doesn't have a mother, so... She doesn't have a mother. Her circumstances of her birth are really questionable to their religion. And she's been labeled as an outcast.
You think one of the robo-dinosaurs spat her out?
That's a very far-fetched possibility.
What's that?
If it turns out to be right, I'm gonna die.
What's that? It's another...
This way, it's the best I can do. He's right behind you. Hi! Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man. But look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but... We can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
Oh, this is creepy.
Show me. Show me again.
I can do. He's right behind you. Hi. Happy birthday,
Aww.
Isaac. Daddy sure
That's
why
for being creepy
the
sad.
But look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
She's a cute kid, at least.
Daddy sure does love his little big man.
That just went from being sad to, or cute to sad. And... data corruption parcel, so that's
what
the only thing.
What happened here?
Another blast door.
Oh, there's pizza boxes? On the table? No. Dang.
I was gonna say, I don't think Papa John's delivered here. If they did, it was fucking some dank-ass pizza by now.
I probably still eat it, dude.
You're fucking sick. I would, yeah, probably me too, to be honest, if I was starving. Like, well, I'm gonna die anyways, might as well be for some fucking pizza.
Right, at least I'll die happy.
I don't know. If it's some old ass pizza, I might not be happy.
Still pizza.
I mean, pizza's pizza, yeah, but there's some shit pizza.
True.
Like,
just gotta go by the pizza scale.
Pizza. Just saying. I didn't say
ooh, thingy! Else. Get the thingy. It's shiny.
You're a thingy.
I don't have a thingy.
Well, happy new year, dear diary. Can you believe we actually celebrated last night? Well, we did. Kind of. Director Evans invited everyone to gather in the community room. Don't know where she got the party hats. That was a ghoulish touch. So there we sit, watching the clock tick down to midnight, and I'm thinking, am I the only one who gets the symbolism of this? It might have been worth it if Skylar had gotten drunk again, but I seem to be a mistake she doesn't want to repeat.
Damn.
Wonderful thing for a 6-year-old to hear.
Right?
She's probably sitting there contemplating, what does that mean?
Or, and or she's more like, bro, I'm also a terrible mistake, I feel ya.
Oh!
Ow! I mean, she is a ginger.
Right.
Right.
I saw them lining up in the community room. Like cattle in a slaughterhouse, but smiling at each other. Chana handing out meds, like being alive is some kind of pain to be eased. Well, not me. I don't want to go quiet. I don't want to trail off. I want a period at the end of my life sentence, not an ellipsis. Hell, an exclamation mark. So if that upsets whoever finds this, too bad.
Did they kill themselves? Was that what that celebration was?
I think so.
Oh,
I heard
sick.
Some foot. See, I stopped the recording because I thought I heard footsteps in the back, and I couldn't tell if it was from the audio playback or the actual something around me. But that was pretty much the gist of it. It's just like, hey, suicide party. Yay.
Mm. That's, dude, that's kind of really messed up.
Yeah. It's even more messed up when you realize that a 6-year-old kid is discovering all this.
Probably doesn't even understand, like, half of it.
Fair point. Tell me to go there.
I mean, regardless.
That's the way I came in. That's blocked off. Yeah, regardless. You're right. Oh, that's another rat. Rat. Thank you. I know where
I don't know.
If
you did hear footsteps, you could probably just use that scanner to pick up whatever else was in the room with you.
Oh, shit. You're right. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Oh, look, it's Connor Chesson again. Data corruption severe. You know, let me play the audio, bro? Oh.
I mean, seriously? Record our thoughts for posterity? Great idea, Director Evans. Like, I haven't done enough for posterity already. Like, I wouldn't be here like this if not for posterity. I'm done with posterity. Posterity can go.
I agree. Posterity can go get self. Who the fuck are you? Huh. Severe data corruption. Kind of what I see.
Why did they die here? What happened?
Um, if you're paying attention, they're having a suicide party.
Again, I don't think she understands that, though.
Alright, fair point.
And pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. I mean, death. I'm sorry. It's been a while. Oh, these meds Johnny gave us are really something. So, okay, from the top, kids. Hail Mary, full of grace.
Were there children?
Those are
too?
Petrified books.
Or was he just being a smartass? Oh, look, there's Skylar. So wait, were there children too, or was he just being a smartass?
I think maybe he was being a smartass. He was on those drums.
Fair one.
Machu Picchu. Always wanted to see that. Never did. Why didn't I go with Owen when he asked? Stupid. Well,
oh wow. Now we got more. You don't get this to it. Or am I not?
Maybe you need to be closer. That got dark.
Oh, it's always
and maybe that's all I need, you know. That moment the door opened and you were standing there wearing that retro wave dress and a wee smile. I had to look away or you were gonna see it on my face. What had just blossomed inside me, you know. It was just an instant, but I knew we'd be forever.
Lesbian.
That's fascinating.
Actually, yes.
Yeah, it's Connor again. Alright. So that's all the data in here.
Yeah, I think we've scanned everything.
Yeah, I think we have scanned everything.
Possibly.
So let's check it. Kind of when I get out of this area before we stop the episode. So there's just so much. Oh, okay.
He found me. Ross found me.
Yeah, and you were in so
down
much
here.
Trouble.
I'm coming.
Speaking of when I get out of here.
Come, girl. Take my hand. You don't belong down there. Come. Such places are forbidden, Aloy.
I fell in.
They are of the metal world. What is that on your face?
Nothing.
Did you find it down there?
No.
Give it to me.
No.
Aloy, such things are dangerous.
No!
Well, if you're gonna go sneaking away from home, you'll need to know how to survive in the wild. Come, Aloy. Home now. But starting tomorrow,
cool.
You will learn to hunt.
He knows what's up.
Hell yeah.
And oh, cutscene. Oh shit.
She's learning how to use it.
She's learning quick.
What do they mean?
Take
Pierce
your bow.
Technology. No shit.
And enough muttering to that plaything. We descend to the valley now. Follow.
You gotta give me a good chance to pause, or are you just gonna keep doing cutscenes? That was really sudden. I was like, I thought something went wrong.
Right? I did too. I was like, no, I fixed this.
You will need to stay close and do as I say.
I know.
You're still scratched up from that fall you took yesterday. So let's start there. Take this medicine pouch. I'll show you how to fill it. See this plant over here? It's called Southbrush.
All right, now I believe that's going to be it for this episode, guys. We will be back in just a little bit with another episode. Y'all stick around and watch it. All right, guys, take it easy.
Bye, everybody.